Good morning.
Good morning.
Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Welcome to Peace Lutheran Church for our sunrise service that is going to be presented by our youth. It is truly a wonderful and glorious day today that we have the opportunity to celebrate this fantastic day as we have gone through 6 weeks of Lent and Holy Week. And it has been somewhat subdued because of our sin and our recognition of it. And now we get to celebrate the fact that Jesus has indeed risen from the dead, of course, many years ago, but we do celebrate this every year so that we are reminded that we have such a blessing through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. But not only that, that we have this opportunity to share that wonderful message to many people who don't know this yet. And I really do appreciate our youth are taking this opportunity as this very early in the morning to tell us that wonderful message once again. And so, therefore, we shall begin. And I'm going to ask you guys to go ahead and let's get started.
Good morning. As we worship here this wonderful Easter morning, I ask that you bow your heads in prayer with me. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us together this morning for a day of true celebration. While we may feel darkness all around us in this earthly life, we are reminded that it is because of your Son, Jesus' death and resurrection, that we will gain eternity in heaven with you. Because of your promise to us, we can go out and be the light in the darkness.
Amen.
Let us pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The introit reading is from Psalm 57. My heart, O God, is steadfast.
My heart is steadfast.
I will sing and make music.
Awake, my soul.
Awake, harp and lyre.
I will awaken God.
I will praise you, Lord, among the nations.
I will sing to you among the peoples.
For great is your love, reaching to the heavens.
Your faithfulness reaches to the skies.
Be exalted, O God, above the heavens. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the
beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The epistle reading for today is from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 19 through 22. If in this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For as by a man came death, by a man had also come the resurrections of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall be all be made alive. This is the word of the Lord. Let us pray. Eternal God, we rejoice in the new life won by Jesus Christ. Through the resurrection, you have defined yourself for mankind, a loving Father, a Father who forgives, a forgiving Father, a Father who promises an eternal future for every one of your trusting children. Death is defeated, love is trumpeted through Jesus Christ our Lord.
For peace.
And we search for hope.
For love.
For joy.
But where do we look?
How can we find the answer?
Do we find the answer with friends?
Or possessions?
Through popularity?
Or sports?
Through music?
Or conformity?
Travel? Through good deeds?
Do we find it in the status?
Or in stardom?
A good job?
Through power?
Travel?
Leisure?
Or the latest cause?
Why can't we find it?
Who will help us?
Who will be our God?
Oh, my bad. I did not realize that.
Jesus answers us through his word. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Please rise for the gospel reading.
The gospel reading for today is from Luke chapter 24. Now that same day, two of them were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem. They were talking with each other about everything that had happened. As they talked and discussed these things with each other, Jesus himself came up and walked along with them, but they were kept from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing together as you walk along?" They stood still, their faces downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, asked him, "Are you the only one visiting Jerusalem who does not know the things that have happened there in these days?" "What things?" he asked. "About Jesus of Nazareth," they replied. "He was a prophet, powerful in word and deed before God and all the people. The chief priests and our rulers handed him over to be sentenced to death, and they crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one who was going to redeem Israel. And what is more, it is the third day since all this took place. In addition, some of our women amazed us. They went to the tomb early this morning but didn't find the body. They came and told us that they had seen a vision of angels who said he was alive. Then some of our companions went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see Jesus. He said to them, 'How foolish you are, and how slow to believe that all the prophets have spoken. Did not the Messiah have to suffer these things and then enter his glory?' And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he explained to them what was said in all the scriptures concerning himself." As they approached the village to which they were going, Jesus continued on as if he were going farther. But they urged him strongly, "Stay with us, for it is nearly evening. The day is almost over." So he went to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and began to give it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he disappeared from their sight. They asked each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he talked with us on the road and opened the scriptures to us?" They got up and returned at once to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 and those with them, assembled together and saying, "It is true. The Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon." Then the two told what had happened on the way and how Jesus was recognized by them when he broke the bread. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us bow our heads for the closing prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, through Jesus' death and resurrection, you have given us eternal life with you. You are our comforter, redeemer, and Lord. We thank you for being near to us, even when we feel that we do not have all the answers. Help us learn to be still and know that you are always in control. In your holy and precious name we pray. Amen. Amen. He is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
We'll will now sing the closing hymn. We are collecting a special offering today at the back of the church to send to the Salvation Army. Thank you for coming to our Sunrise Youth Worship Service. Please join us for a pancake and sausage breakfast immediately following the service. Thank you.
Please be seated. That went very smoothly. That means they've practiced. Thank you for all your work in preparing this service, and thank you for the message that you delivered today, and thank you especially to Amy for coordinating the whole thing. Appreciate all your work. Yeah. And now the schedule is that breakfast is supposed to start at 7:45, I've told. So if we're a little bit early for that, that's okay, but that'll be in the fellowship hall. And then Easter egg hunt will start at 8:30, and the Lord has given us good weather, so we should be able to do that outside. My understanding is the younger ones will be on the Panther Way side of the church, and then the older ones will be on the parking lot side where most people park. Is that correct? Or is it the other way around? All the way around. Okay. Well, good somebody knows. So at least we'll have separate places for the older and the younger kids so that everybody should get a good chance. Okay. Then the divine service will begin at 9. And after the divine service, we'll have tours available. Pastor Ryan Nearson will be offering explanation of our stained glass windows since he was involved in designing them. When you sit by a stained glass window Sunday after Sunday, because usually you sit in the same place, right? If you ever thought about, okay, what does that mean and how does it fit with the others? We'll get a chance to learn a little bit more about that after the service this morning. So thank you all for coming. The Lord is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah. Okay.
rearranging my lilies?
What's that?
Are you rearranging my lilies?
I am. I'm putting the fresher ones to the front.
I'm not doing it.
Don't be offended.
Oh, I'm not.
Okay. I'm just turning the pot around.
Well, the reason some of them are the way they are is because of the way they were leaning, and I had to just turn them.
They're what? Leaning?
They were like kind of leaning, you know.
You're right. I've been in congregations where they have members of the congregation get Easter lilies for the family, but they don't do that here.
No, but who was it was telling me? The council was telling me that they were doing that at St. Paul this year. And they had like 60 people buy Easter lilies, and when they went to pick them up, they didn't have
Did you look?